Hello, everybody. This is Pastor Paul with the Weekly Devo. You know, this week, as we finished off the book of Acts, I wanted to share out of Acts chapter 26 today. I'm going to read from verse 27. And it says, King Agrippa, do you believe the prophets? I know that you do believe. Then Agrippa said to Paul, you almost persuade me to become a Christian. And Paul said, I would to God and not only that not only you, but also all who hear me today might become both almost and altogether such as I am, except for these chains. When he had said these things, the king stood up, as well as the governor and Bernice and those who sat with them. And when they had gone aside, they talked among themselves, saying, this man is doing nothing deserving of death or chains. Then Agrippa said to Festus, this man might have been set free if he had not appealed to Caesar. If you have been following along in the book of Acts, towards the end of the book, it records Paul's persecution and his arrest as he makes his journey back to Jerusalem. And as he was arrested, he was even beaten up, and he also faced a series of trials. And here in Acts chapter 26, we see Paul actually being able to speak before Festus, who was the governor at that time of the region, but coincidentally, King Agrippa, who was pretty much the king of that region at that time, his official title, I believe, was a tetrarch. King Agrippa had visited Governor Festus, and Festus, realizing that, hey, Agrippa, being the king of this region here, he's very familiar with the Jewish customs and their religious order. Hey, we have this guy, Paul, and he's, you know, the Jews want to bring charges against him. Hey, King Agrippa, why don't you hear him out? You know, I'm sure you could definitely help us out here. And of course, King Agrippa, you know, piqued his interest. So here, there was Paul standing before King Agrippa, sharing the gospel. And Paul, knowing what he knew exactly what he was doing, he reached all the way back to his Jewish roots, you know, his days as a Pharisee, and he kind of packaged the gospel in the most digestible way for King Agrippa. And he almost, it seems like, succeeded. Because in verse 28, Agrippa said to Paul after all this, you almost persuade me to become a Christian. But of course, you know, we don't know exactly what happens to King Agrippa. Most likely he didn't accept the gospel to the end. But what's significant here is, end of this story here, we see, you know, Agrippa and Festus, they're talking amongst themselves. And King Agrippa came to the conclusion, same conclusion that Pontius Pilate, you know, came to with Jesus Christ. And he said, this man hasn't done anything. There is no charges that can even be brought. He shouldn't even be arrested, let alone being put to death. And he actually tells, you know, Festus in verse 32, this man might have been set free if he had not appealed to Caesar. See, what had happened was right before this, you know, King Agrippa came to Festus, Paul had sort of used his Roman citizenship right to tell Festus, the governor, hey, I appeal to Caesar. I want to take this to the highest court possible. And I want, you know, the king's, you know, Caesar to, you know, put me to trial. And I want him to hear me out. And I want to make my case before him. And so, you know, he's a Roman citizen, so he had the right to do that. And that's why Agrippa is telling Festus, if he hadn't done that, he would have been set free. You know, if you go back to Acts chapter 23, we see the ultimate reason why Paul made his appeal to be heard before Caesar. There was a time when he was, you know, just going through the persecution and he was under arrest and he was going through a tough time. You know, people were trying to assassinate him even. And I'm sure his spirit was down. God had actually appeared to Paul to encourage him. And God told Paul in Acts 23 verse 11, be of good cheer. For as you have testified for me in Jerusalem, so you must also bear witness at Rome. What does that indicate? That Paul was actually, in appealing to Caesar, he was simply obeying the will of God that was for his life at that time. And you know, I couldn't help but sort of think, isn't that our life today? Isn't that the lives of all the saints in all the churches today? You know, when we seek to do the will of God, when we seek to obey the words of God, such as love even your enemies, turn the other cheek, go another mile if they seek to, ask you to go a mile with you. When we try to obey the words of God and we try to carry out His will for us in all of our lives, there will be times when it's going to cost us. There will be times when it's going to feel like we're making a sacrifice. I think about, and of course, a lot of it was in my flesh. I think about times when, I would sort of say to myself, oh, if I had not known Jesus Christ, if it wasn't for God in my life, I would have thrown that punch. I would have said those extra choice, statements with those choice words. I would say those words back at the, back at them and fight back. But of course, God, the Holy Spirit, of course, in us sort of held us back at times. And we think back to what Jesus did ultimately. And what Jesus did here on earth from day one to the very day, he breathed his last. Everything came at a cost for the Lord. And you know what? If we're going to model our lives after our Lord as we're supposed to, as we seek to imitate Christ in our lives here on earth, there will be times like what Paul's facing in this story when we seek to do that, to follow after the image of Christ. It's going to come at a cost at times. And we could have been set free, quote unquote, if you will. But sometimes we're bound by the words of God, by God's command, by God's will for our lives to go the extra mile for that person, to give that extra generosity, to be more gracious to that person, love even the most unlovable person in our lives, if it means that it could give an opportunity for that person to come to know Christ, to hear the gospel. And so I want to encourage you today, as the word of God has encouraged me, that when you seek to serve those around you, when you are at a place where you have to love even the most unlovable person in your life, forgive the most unforgivable offense and person in your life, may you place your hope in the Lord. Because you know what? If God is asking us to do these things, He's going to also give us the strength. He's going to also give us the heart of love that we need and the right amount of grace that we need each day to do just that. So let's continue to press forward. Let's continue our walk in the Lord and continue to carry out His will for our lives. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we humbly acknowledge and admit that at times to do your will, at times living according to your word is difficult. And it feels like it's coming at a great cost. Lord, gently remind us at those times what it meant for you to live your life here on earth, what it cost you when you went to the slaughter, if you will, for our sins. And Lord, you are simply asking us to bear maybe just a tiny fraction of what it cost you so that we can be used by you to continue to shine the light of the gospel in this dark world. So Lord, we humbly ask that you would use us. Give us the strength that we need. Give us the love that we need. Give us more of your grace so that we can continue to share the gospel to those around us, so that we may continue to bear the image of Christ and carry out your will for our lives. We thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.